Do you mind if I run the camera?
Oh, it's fine. It's fine, yeah.
Oh, a lot of fun.
It is a lot of it, yeah.
Hmm.
All kinds of stuff.
Hmm.
Amazing.
Whoa! That thing's got some heft to it.
It does.
Jeez.
What's this, Chevrolet?
Chrysler.
Chrysler, okay. Well, that explains it.
Bridges is Madison County.
Yeah, baby. Got one of these at home.
There are some cool stuff.
Huh?
There was a ton of cool stuff here.
Yeah? Yeah. Hmm. Hmm. Mm. Need a bigger truck. Registered.
Boxes.
Would you like to tell the YouTubers about your place?
Sure.
And yourself, and anything you want to say at all?
Well, sure. Hi.
You might start just saying, I'm Richard. What's your name?
My name's Jimmy. Jimmy Poss. I've been out here about 22 years. Been taking down old buildings for about 35. Everything is architectural salvage, and we do vintage clothes and a lot of heart pine wood. The buildings we've got here were built in the late 1800s, ranged from a grocery store to a drugstore to the bank to a hardware store.
So that was all these lined up right here. So this would be like Main Street where all the stuff was at, right?
This is, I guess, one of the original strip malls.
Yeah, back from back in the day.
Long time ago, yeah.
Yeah. That's awesome.
It's just my wife and I. We don't do any booth or consignment here at all. We just, it's all something we love to do, so.
Yeah. Well, I appreciate you letting me look. So we're down in the heart of Carlton, Georgia. What's the name of this store?
Neat Pieces Antiques.
Neat Pieces. Okay.
It's a really interesting state park down the road.
We just came from there.
You did?
Yeah.
That's a really neat place.
It is a neat place. I was surprised when I came up on the bridge and you could drive over it. I used to live in Dawsonville before the bridge burned down. Well, actually, I came to Dawsonville right after the bridge burned down, but I used to drive across it. But I didn't expect they'd let cars go across it, but they were just doing it, you know. I was like, okay.
We go there a couple of times a week.
Oh, yeah.
Breakfast, we just walk the trails.
Now, when you say to breakfast, you carry your own, or do they serve? Yeah. And you know, it's great. I saw so many people out on the river playing on the rocks and swimming and picnicking and all kind of good stuff going on there.
It's a neat place.
Yeah. You just never know what people are going to come up with, do you?
You really don't. Had somebody bring me a cowhide today.
I saw that cowhide down there. That's a beautiful thing. Yeah, for real.
I post a lot on Instagram.
Do you?
I posted today. I said, you never know what's going to show
you
up.
You just never do. I worked in a leather tannery up in Maine when I first went up there for a number of years.
So you're down this way?
To stay.
To stay.
I was born and raised here. I went over the road truck driving when they, you know, there was a time when they weren't in the interstates and they started paving everything. And it looked to me like they were going to pave the whole state. So I started looking for a place less crowded. Went over the road and wound up in Maine, stayed up for 35 years or so. And my wife brought her down to Georgia. She fell in love with her. So I said, okay, why not go live there? She says people ain't no nicer nowhere than they are right here. So, I mean, that's coming from a Cape Cod girl. That's a big deal, you know? Yeah. So, she said you can live anywhere in the world, but you can't get around people as nice as they are right down here. So we selling a house and up there and moving down here. I got one like that, but it's real. That car there.
A full size one?
Yep. Doesn't have a roof on it, but other than that, it's just like that. Yeah. Yeah, it is. Yeah,
I got
I'm gonna I got an old Rambler down here already, but I got a neighbor who wants to come to Georgia, so I don't know if you can make it out on my credit card, but that's it sitting on the left there.
Oh, yeah, look at that.
And I'm getting rid of a lot of old cars, but I'm keeping that one. And I'm looking forward to having it down here, you know.
It's a Ford or Chevy on your right?
Well, that's a 55 Ford wagon.
Ford wagon.
Yeah. That was a fine car. I sold that to a young fella up in New York who I knew would take good care of it. Yeah, I'm looking forward to getting it down here and driving it around a little bit. It's kind of like this place, just made out of stuff I collected along the way.
Yeah, this looked like it was kind of put together.
Yeah. Actually, that cow skin looked real good on the front seat.
That's a big one, too.
Yeah, big enough to cover my front seat.
It's 7 feet by 5 feet, I think, something like that.
Huh. Well, just for the sake of advertisement and all, what would you get for something like that?
Well, we've got 150 on it.
Yeah, that's a fair price.
Yeah.
You know, for a piece of, well, having worked in a leather tannery, I'm an expert on such as that. So I'm proclaiming it to be so that it's a fair price.
That's good. That's good. That's real good.
You don't get no higher recommendation than that.
So how long have you been doing the YouTube stuff?
You know, I started when nobody knew what it was, including myself. I was a truck driver. I moved off to Maine. My boy, when I was young enough to teach him something, I was too dumb to stay home. I was out on the road and stuff. So his mom raised him, and I went all over the country, and I settled down. Well, I didn't really settle down, but I moved all my stuff to Maine. He said at a certain point after he was grown that he wished I'd been around to teach him how to do things. And somebody had given me a camera that shot video, which amazed me because that was such technology as I'd never imagined. And then I was looking online, I saw some funny videos, and then I looked, this was back when they was just inventing it all, you know. And then there was this thing called YouTube, and it said you can put your own video up. And I thought, no, that can't be real. So I shot a little video, 15 seconds long, put it up, and then there it was. And I called my boy, I said, hey, there's this new thing, this YouTube thing. I just put a video up and show you how to adjust the valves on a Rambler. And that was 10, 11, 09, a long time ago. 09, that'd be, yeah, 10, 11 years. That's about how long YouTube's been around. Now I got over 10,000 videos out there.
Do you really?
Just one after another, they just piled up.
Well,
videos on everything.
What's your site called?
R Peak. My first name's Richard, my last name's Peak. Like I'm taking a peek at that Carlton sign. R Peak. If you type in R Peak. And pick a subject. You can type in R-Peak banjo, R-Peak hot rods, R-Peak rat rods, R-Peak antique stuff, R-Peak fixed stuff. Doesn't matter. Because I got so many, you know, you just never know where you're going to land. What the heck is this coming down the road? Oh, it's a train. You know, I got people out there that just love trains. There are people that'll just sit and watch a train go by. I used to work with a bunch of boys that built boxcars. I had a best friend that was a retired train conductor. What all are you buying? Oh, it's a lighthouse. He's a hubcap man. Amazing, ain't it? Yeah. They used to call it graffiti, now they call it artwork. How many hubcaps did he buy?
He's got one, I think.
57 Ford. Well, he'll, if he doesn't leave with an arm load, I'd be surprised, because he collects hubcaps. He's got me trained to pick up hubcaps for him everywhere I go. Yeah.
Must be a car train, call it hauling cars, you know?
Yeah, could be. While I'm sitting here conversing with this young man, did you want me to ask him how much for that thing that you wanted? Did you want me to ask him how much he wanted for that thing that you liked?
No,
not today. Not today. This would be a good place to sit and play the banjo. Wouldn't it? Yeah.
Where's that rock that she was going to show me?
Oh, yeah.
I know at least one YouTuber out there that fixes up these old fans and puts them in a box and resells them. There's a couple right here in Carlton, Georgia. Oh, Eric's already found a 57 Ford hubcap. There's another one of them fans back there. That one's got the motor with it. Look at these chairs. Lord have mercy. I ain't seen nothing like that before. Huh. Oh, there's one of them metal sinks. Oh, there's another one. Man, it's a good thing I'm not building a house down here. I'd be all over that. Huh. Hmm. Look at all the fans and fan blades up there. Huh.
Oh. Boy, some good looking shelving right here. Huh.